觉。
Hey, this is Aaron Walker of Spotlight Studios. You're learning Crash Into Me by Dave Matthews Band. This is a bit of a more advanced song, so good luck. All right, so let's talk about the chords. There's a couple of things to talk about. Chords, the times that the chords change, the rhythm of it, and then actually the strum pattern, which we need to take it each a step at a time. So for all five of these chords, one, two, three, four, five, six chords, let's figure it out whenever we get there. There's going to be four notes that are common to every single chord, okay? So the four notes that are common, second fret of the D, fourth fret of the G, and then the open B and E. Okay, so you can play those four, just like that, with your first and fourth finger, okay? Those notes are all going to stay the same on every single chord. What's going to change are the bass notes. It's going to go from C sharp, then A, and then a B, and then E, G sharp, A, B, and then E. Okay, so C sharp, A, B, and E. You can think of that as one phrase. Memorize that shape. And then memorize the second shape. G sharp, A, B, E. That one, they're very similar. It's just the starting note, the root note changes for each one. The first time it starts on C sharp, and then both go A, B, E. Well, the second time it goes G sharp, and then A, B, E. So that might help you think about it that way. So it's always some chord, A, B, E, and then the time that what it changes is from C sharp the first time to G sharp the second time, okay? Let's see if that makes sense. So the first chord is gonna be, like I said, C sharp with your third finger with the common notes, the second and fourth frets of the D and the G. And then you let off your, and notice on this that I'm muting the bottom string with my second finger because I really want to be deliberate with that bass line. That's kind of what sets the guitar part apart, is that it's really identifiable as this song if you can. You should be able to hear clearly those bass notes. That's what you're going for, okay? So to do that, I don't want this muddy E at the bottom. I want to mute that so you can hear that C sharp right there. Okay, now to go to the A, we're going to let off the third finger. And I'm still using that second finger to mute. Then I'm going to go bring my first finger down to the second fret of the A. Okay, now what's important about that one, similar to the first time, slightly similar, is I'm muting the bottom string, but this time I'm muting it with my first finger. So the first finger is doing like triple duty here. It's holding down the second fret of the A, holding down the second fret of the D, and it's also muting the bottom E string, okay? So what you should be going for, if you could just practice just this chord right here, you want the bottom muted, you wanna hear the second fret of the A, you wanna hear the second fret of the D, you wanna hear the fourth fret of the B, you wanna hear the B, and you wanna hear the E. So that's pretty much a doozy. Okay, the triple duty right there on your first finger. All right, so the first three chords. Oops, look at that. That was terrible because I had that open E right there. That's what I'm telling you to avoid. And then now we're gonna go to an E. We're gonna just shift this first finger a little bit up so that you can hear that open E. So you're going for a deliberate, it's a similar chord shape on both, but the bass note is crucial. So this time I want you to hear the bass note is the B, And then when I shift this finger up a little bit, I want you to hear the E as the bass note. So listen for... So you're listening for... It's like while all of the strings on top of the A, all of that, what am I doing? All of that remains constant. You really got to hear that bass is the difficult part. The next chord is the G sharp. So we still have our first and our pinky at the second and the fourth of the D and the G. We're going to put our third finger instead of at the C sharp. We're going to bring it down a string, okay? And I'm muting the A string this time around with that third finger. Just like that. It's also okay for my first finger to touch the A this way too, to give the A is being muted by both the third finger and the first finger. So if I get a little crazy and sloppy later on, I'll have a better chance. What you don't want, you hear that G sharp in the A. As kind of cool as that chord is, it's not what we're going for here. Okay, so that's the G sharp, go up to the A, and then you go to the B. So now we need to talk about when to change the chords. So those were the chords. Here we go. Here's how you change them. How you count it out. 1E and a 2E and a 3E. All right. So we're counting in 16th notes, okay? So it's 1E and a 2E and a 3E. It's not 3E and, it's the 3E. So it really jumps in at you, okay? So 1E and a 2E and a 3E. All right. Let's do it again. 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E. Then to go to the B, you do it on beat 1. And then to go to that bottom E, you do it on that 3E again. Okay, so what I'm saying is 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E. Okay, let's do that together. 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E. You notice that every one is a downstroke and every E is an upstroke, and you're gonna see why here in a minute when we actually do this drum pattern. Same thing, here we go. 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Okay, now let's do the second chord progression. Let's start the G sharp and then the A and then the B and then the E. 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a same thing. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E. All right, now let's do both phrases together, right? 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Do it again, we're gonna do it twice in a row. 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1. All right. So that's how you change the chords. What kind of beat you change the chord on. But there's a lot of strumming going on between those chord changes, right? So let's figure those out. It's going to be 1E and a 2E and a 3E. Okay, so that's down, 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 up, down. Up is the E that you need to be on the A. Okay, so to do the strum pattern well, you can't really just stay on one chord and just practice the strum pattern. You've got to do the chord changes in the strum pattern to really hear what you're doing, okay? Because it's crucial to hear how you change the root note of the bass, okay? So, here we go. It's gonna be 1E and a 2E and a 3E. So So on 3E, on 3 you hear the C sharp, but then on the E you hear the A. Listen for that. A 1E and a 2E and a 3E. That's the first change. What's the next change? How do I break that down? Practice like this. It's a up, down, 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 up. Ready, go. Ready, go. This really helps if you move your arm like this, and when I say go, hit, and then play. Go. 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 That's how you change like the A part. So those two together is from the C sharp to the A. One E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Let's do it slow. 4 E and a 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. This is a challenge. Ready, go. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Ready, go. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Last time. 4 E and a 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. And then you do the same thing on the next two chords. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Like I'm talking about, the bass notes changing clearly is the most important part. So just practice like, just do the change. If you're hearing, you're doing it right. Now, if I'm not mistaken, the second phrase does that same rhythm, so I'm not gonna like belabor, how do I say that? Belabor? Is that a word? Maybe I made that up. Did that one wrong. I didn't change on the E. Rhythm, and you'll notice on the actual record it's a lot faster than that, so that's gonna be a challenge. Let's do the next chords. Crash into me. So there's that little chorus part. He doesn't really play chords for that walk up. He just plays the C sharp, the G sharp, A, B. So that's the 4, 5, 7, and then the E major, which we haven't used yet. And then he goes to this, I'm gonna call it a D over F sharp, D5 over F sharp maybe, because he got this little D5, but then the F sharp's down here. Okay. And you go crash. They do that a little bit out of time. I couldn't quite put the click track on the demonstration that you watched because I don't think they recorded the album with the click track, because I could not get it to to stick with it. Anyways, and so that part is really kind of timey, is what I call it. To go to that D5 over F sharp, just kind of, you got to listen to the song and feel it out for the rhythm. So there's the D5 over F sharp, and then you start the song over. Hey, and really, you don't really do like a... If you listen closely, it's more of like you just hit the bass note to start the song off. That replaces your first down stroke. You just hit that single note. Sorry. So like to do it really lightly too. One other change, and it happens during the jam after the first chorus, and it happens one more time in the song, but it's whenever you hear the whatever that is. So it's going to be four bars of C sharp minor. It goes to A, B, and then E, and then G sharp, A, B, and then E, and then right back. I say right back, I'm talking about that's verse two. Okay, so here we go. It's after the chorus, the D. I'm gonna try to play it from the and I'm coming to you. Do that again. Starts here. Go to A. Verse. All right, so if you have any questions about that part, go ahead and leave me a comment, because that it really, the timing on that is really a challenge, okay? So I think that's all I have to say about this song. It is a good song. It is a challenge, especially if you're pinky. It's really, it'll build your pinky strength a big time. Because, like, even when I was doing that demonstration, I'm getting tired of holding my pinky like that for so, so long. But, yeah, just keep practicing and having fun playing music. Hey, leave me some love on this video, please. And if I help you with the guitar, then share it with your friends. I just want to help people make music, okay? So come back to the Spotlight Studios YouTube page soon. All right, see ya.